Hi, I'm Andy from the Brainstormers, and in this video we'll be talking about three major building systems used in FTC. They are Tetrix, Actobotics, and goBILDA. So now we'll be talking about channels. First up is Tetrix, which is the oldest building system. It has a non-consistent hole pattern, which makes it very difficult to attach to other parts. Next is Actobotics. It is a newer building system that is based off imperial measurements, and it's also worked off some of the flaws that Tetrix encountered. Most notably is the consistent hole pattern, which makes it much easier to attach parts in a variety of positions. Finally, we have goBILDA, the newest of the major building systems. It is from the Actobotics family, but it uses Tetrix measurements, and it also features a bigger space in between the plates. Its hole pattern is also consistent, but it does have the ovals in case people want to make slight adjustments with their mounting. Now we'll be talking about beams. This is the Tetrix one. It features a consistent hole pattern, but it is quite thin, so it is easily bendable. Actobotics has two different types of beams. This first one is thicker than Tetrix's. It also has a consistent hole pattern. It is a really good tool for when you need to connect things structurally, but you don't want the size of a channel. Their next one is a mini channel. It is useful when combining mini beams for Actobotics or other structural things where you don't need as much strength. We have two different types of goBILDA beams. This one is a square beam that features through holes, but it does have tapped holes on the end so that you can connect beams together. This is also useful for structural components where you don't want the massive size of the goBILDA channels. goBILDA also sells these L brackets, which are very useful for connecting corners and making them structurally sound. So now we'll be talking about L brackets. They are very useful for connecting channels together or whenever you need a corner. This first one is a Tetrix rounded corner L bracket. This fits inside of a channel, but it is quite flimsy and can easily be bent. Now we have the Tetrix square bracket. It does not fit inside of a channel, but provides the same usage as the rounded one otherwise. Now moving on to Actobotics, they feature a square L-bracket as well, which is quite similar to the Tetrix square one, but it just has more holes, which fits the Actobotics hole pattern. This also does not fit inside of a channel. This slightly beefier Actobotics rounded corner features threaded holes, and it fits inside of a channel, but most importantly, it is much stronger and resistant to bending. Lastly, for Actobotics, we have this 90-degree bracket. It features only two threaded holes, so it is used for mounting in the corners, but it also has a 45-degree angle in case you need that. This is also very strong, considering it has the three forms of a triangle. Like the other building systems, goBILDA has a standard L-bracket with all the same usages, but it just fits their hole pattern. Next up for goBILDA is the beefy bracket. It is the same as the Actobotics one, but it just fits the goBILDA hole pattern, and it also has the threaded holes. goBILDA also has the 45-degree triangle bracket. It has five threaded holes. It still has the 45-degree mounting, but it also features holes on the side in case you need to mount it in that. Lastly, we have the goBILDA small L bracket. It has a square pattern of holes, which is more limited than the L bracket, but it has some threaded holes, so you can mount it in this small, compact way. We'll be talking about motion components now for all the building systems. The first one is the Tetrix 4.7mm D-shaft. This can be easily bent by another robot, so it is not recommended. Now we have the Actobotics quarter-inch D-shaft, which is slightly bigger than the Tetrix one, and it can still be bent, but it is also very useful inside of your robot where it's protected. Last up for axles is the goBILDA 8mm Rex, which features the hexagonal pattern and has the threaded inside. It even has the E-clip, which acts as a coupler, and this is much stronger than any of the axles we've talked about previously. Now talking about bearings and bushings, we have the Tetrix bushing. This is not recommended because it does not have the ball bearings, so it doesn't really create a smooth motion in your robot. It can bind up axles, and it's just not as smooth. Now we have the Actobotics quarter-inch bearing with the flange. This one creates a much smoother experience than the Tetrix bushing. Finally, we have the goBILDA 8mm Rex bearing, which also creates a smooth motion when paired with its axle. Now we'll be talking about hubs. This one is the Tetrix 4.7mm hub. It fits on the axle, and then when you want to tighten, you tighten the set screw onto that part of the D shaft, that flat part of the D shaft. This is not recommended because it can damage some spots on the D shaft, which can eventually cause your shaft not to fit through bushings. Now we have the Actobotics quarter inch clamping hub. This is much better than the set screws because there's no risk about damaging the axles, and it's very simple just to tighten this screw on the side. Finally, we have the goBILDA 8mm Rex Sonic hub. This has similar features to the clamping hub, but it has two screws so you get a tighter fit. This is a Tetrix motion component. It features the bushings, the channel, the axle, and a Tetrix omni-wheel. It is the least smooth of them all because of the bushings. Next up is an Actobotics motion component. It is either the smoothest or the second smoothest. It features their bearings, their quarter inch axle, a coupler, and the hub. It also features some spacers to make sure that there's as little friction as possible. Finally, we have the goBILDA motion component. This does not need a coupler because it has the E-clip as we talked about on the axle. It also features the 8mm Rex axle. Now we'll just look at some ways to mount motors onto Actobotics and goBILDA channels. So for this one, this is Actobotics, and you can see there's an adapter part needed to make sure that the hull pattern matches up. But when we transfer to goBILDA, it is even easier because the goBILDA motor fits up with the hull pattern on the goBILDA channels. All you need is some screws. Finally, we have a goBILDA channel with a motor inside of it, which just shows the size and why it is that size. It also is mounted using this piece, which shows that you can mount it pointing out. So for takeaways, we would not recommend the Tetrix building system as it is not being developed as much, and it is far behind Actobotics and goBILDA. If you are currently using Actobotics, we say you should stick with it because it is, while goBILDA is slightly better, it is not worth the cost to make that complete jump. But if you are a new team or you are using goBILDA, we think that you should stay with it or look to purchase it because it is the best building system and they're developing the most new parts for it. Thank you.